Thank you, God, for the gift of education, for our children's desire to learn and grow, for friends who have similar interests, but who challenge them in new ways too. We pray their educators are inspired and energized every day by their calling. We pray this year would be led by you. Each day they would step through the door you open. Keep them safely protected, and may you bless them with opportunities to be a light to others as they learn more about you. We ask for wisdom and strength to raise them up in the purpose and plan you have for them, and the truth of your word. Amen.
Well, good morning. We're glad you're all here on this beautiful sunny day. Those of you who are able, I ask you to stand and worship with us now as we praise the Lord.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. There's salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long, praising my Savior all the day long.
Thank you. Trust and obey, Where the dearest and best for us.
trophies at last I lay down, and I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old
thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for this beautiful weather you gave us. Thank you for this time together to fellowship and praise you, Father, and to learn about you. We just praise you for that. And just open our hearts and minds, too, for what Pelly has for us this morning. And just be with us all now. And we thank you in Jesus' name. And now we have Tony with the children's message.
Before I finished working, I was a teacher and a principal for a long time, 43 years, really old, okay? And school's about to start, right? When does school start here? Isn't that awful? I don't know. My grandkids start tomorrow. When does school start here? Some of us. Oh, still doing after Labor Day? So many are going into August now. So, so you have a little bit more time. But I know that you are looking forward to school. Aren't you? Yes, of course you are. So, this is going to be hard because Kehlani just does not love to talk here in front of all of us. But what's something you want a teacher to do? Be kind. Would that be good? Yeah. Do you want a teacher to help you? Like if you need help with something? Oh, you should see the eyes. The eyes are great here. Okay. Do you want a teacher to listen to you? Like if you have a question or something, good if the teacher listens to you. What do you think a teacher wants from you? Okay, out there. What does a teacher want from?
Good grades. Raise your hand.
Really? There. We'll have to teach them a few things, right? Pay attention, listen, do well, work hard, things like that. So, Paul was teaching. Paul was a teacher. And he was teaching the Jewish people all kinds of things. He taught them about the laws of Moses. Like rules, okay, teachers do that. He was talking about the words of the prophets. Do you know what a prophet is? I mean, you don't really talk about prophets a lot, but prophets would get a message from God and they would share it with people. Hey, this is what's going to happen. And so Paul was sharing words from the prophet. He was also talking about Jesus and Jesus' life and what it would mean to follow Jesus and to live a life for Jesus. And the people were not great listeners. Have you had some kids in class ever like that who aren't great listeners? Sometimes we even aren't great listeners, right? You look out sometimes and you go, they're not being as good listeners as they could be. I mean, she probably caught me not listening as well as I could be. So there might be someone else. Maybe just me. Maybe just me. So have you had a teacher in a class, if kids aren't listening, that they have something they do to get kids' attention? Like if they say 1, 2, 3, what do the kids say? Do you know? 1, 2, 3.
Eyes on me.
Eyes on me. How about this? Flat tire. Do you know what? Does your teacher do flat tire? She does. She knows flat tire. Do you know flat tire?
I know.
The teacher says flat tire, and all the kids go, shh. There are many of these, aren't there? Yeah, there are so many that teachers use. And if they still aren't listening, how does the teacher feel?
Awful.
Awful. Frustrated?
Frustrated.
Yeah. Sometimes even angry. You know, it's annoying to be trying to teach. You've prepared. You've got important things for your students to know, just like Paul did. And if they aren't listening, it's kind of frustrating. And Paul got frustrated. And he shared some words from the prophet Isaiah. And let's see if I can put it all together. He said, the Holy Spirit spoke through your forefathers when he said through the prophet Isaiah, go to this people and say, you will be ever hearing, but never understanding. You will be ever seeing, but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become calloused. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Well, what if when Pastor Kelly was preaching, we did this. You should see her face now. She's going, there is no way. That would be awful. Or what if we just closed our eyes? That would be a bad response. But it's kind of what the people were doing. He said they're not listening. They're not understanding. They're not looking at what's happening around them. And so we can hear, like, words go in our ears, but we don't really listen, you know, and think about what they mean. Or we can see things that God is doing around us, but not even pay attention and not understand all that God is doing. God is working all the time, all around us, in our church. Oh, my goodness, the things he's doing in our church.
Amen.
In your school, and God's going to be there. He's already there waiting for you to get there. He's in our neighborhoods. He's in the grocery store. And are we paying attention? Are we watching for what God is doing? The rest of verse 28 says, or verse 27 says, otherwise, so here's this, not seeing, not hearing, not perceiving, not understanding. And the other side is this. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and in turn, here comes the promise, I would heal them. And you don't have to be sick in your body to be healed. You can be sick in your heart, like I just am sad, or I'm lonely, or I'm afraid, or I'm frustrated. I had all those feelings this weekend. Because I was away and I checked my cameras on my house and I saw that while I was gone, my garage door had somehow opened on its own. And I watched a man taking things out of my garage on Saturday morning. I had all those feelings. Frustration, anger. Yeah, how dare he, right?
Right.
But I have decided that I'm supposed to pray for him. Because at 3:24 in the morning, he should be sleeping soundly and comfortably in a bed. And why is he in my garage taking things?
Why would you do it?
it. I saw it in the morning when I checked all my camera feeds. No. But we have to look at what can happen when we're paying attention to what God has to say. Because it says, otherwise I will heal them. So let's be paying attention. Let's be looking for what God is doing. Let's keep our eyes and our ears and our hearts open. Can we pray? Okay. Dear Lord, we thank you for your word that we can apply to all different things in our lives. Please help us so that we can see and we can hear and we can focus on you so that you can heal our hearts, heal our bodies, and use us to spread your word and your love to everyone we meet. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Caitlin.
Well, welcome home, everyone. It's really wonderful to see all of your beautiful faces. And welcome home, Vicente. Come and help me today as we are preaching in the final verses of the book of Acts. Can you believe it's been 4 years that we've been in the book of Acts? I know some of you just visit us every summer, and we're still in Acts, but today it's going to be over.
Estamos estudiando el libro de los Hechos. Ya es el último pasaje que vamos a estudiar, el último sermón. Y pueden creer que han pasado ya,
how many years?
Cuatro años estudiando este libro.
But today we are talking about the kingdom of God from Acts chapter 28.
Hoy vamos a estar hablando acerca del reino de Dios en el capítulo 28.
Acts chapter 28, starting with verse 17.
Vamos a empezar con el verso 17.
3 days later, he called together the local Jewish leaders. When they had assembled, Paul said to them, "My brothers, although I have done nothing against our people or against the customs of our ancestors, I was arrested in Jerusalem and handed over to the Romans."
3 días más tarde, Pablo convocó a los dirigentes de los judíos. Cuando estuvieron reunidos, les dijo, "A mí, hermanos, a pesar de no haber hecho nada contra mi pueblo ni contra las costumbres de nuestros antepasados, me arrestaron en Jerusalén y me entregaron a los romanos."
They examined me and wanted to release me, but because I was not guilty of any crime deserving death.
Estos me interrogaron y quisieron soltarme por no ser yo culpable de ningún delito que mereciera la muerte.
The Jews objected, so I was compelled to make an appeal to Caesar. I certainly did not intend to bring any charge against my own people.
Cuando los judíos se opusieron, me vi obligado a apelar al emperador. Pero no porque tuviera alguna acusación que presentar contra mi nación.
For this reason, I have asked to see you and to talk with you.
Por este motivo, he pedido verlos y hablar con ustedes. Precisamente por la esperanza de Israel, estoy encadenado.
It is because of the hope of Israel that I am bound with this chain. They replied, "We have not received any letters from Judea concerning you, and none of our people who have come from there have reported or said anything bad about you."
Nosotros no hemos recibido ninguna carta de Judea que tenga que ver contigo, le contestaron ellos. Ni ha llegado ninguno de los hermanos de allá con malos informes o que haya hablado mal de ti.
But we want to hear what your views are, for we know that people everywhere are talking against this sect.
Pero queremos oír tu punto de vista, porque lo único que sabemos es que en todas partes se habla en contra de esta secta.
They arranged to meet with Paul on a certain day and came in even larger numbers to the place where he was staying. He witnessed to them from morning till evening, explaining about the kingdom of God and from the law of Moses and from the prophets. He tried to persuade them about Jesus.
Señalaron un día para reunirse con Pablo y acudieron en mayor número a la casa donde estaba alojado. Desde la mañana hasta la tarde estuvo explicándoles y testificándoles acerca del reino de Dios y tratando de convencerlos con respecto a Jesús, partiendo de la ley de Moisés y de los profetas.
Some of them were convinced by what he said, but others would not believe.
Unos se convencieron por lo que él decía, pero otros se negaron a creer.
They disagreed among themselves and began to leave after Paul had made this final statement. The Holy Spirit spoke the truth to your ancestors when he said through Isaiah the prophet.
No pudieron ponerse de acuerdo entre sí y comenzaron a irse cuando Pablo añadió la última declaración. Con razón el Espíritu Santo les habló a sus antepasados por medio de los profetas. Isaías diciendo,
go to this people and say, you will be ever hearing but never understanding. You will be ever seeing but never perceiving.
Ve a este pueblo y dile, por mucho que oigan, no entenderán. Por mucho que vean, no percibirán.
For this people's hearts have become callous. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them.
Porque el corazón de este pueblo se ha vuelto insensible. Se le han tapado los oídos y han cerrado los ojos. De lo contrario, podrían ver con los ojos, oír con los oídos, entender con el corazón y convertirse, y yo lo sanaría.
Therefore, I want you to know that God's salvation has been sent to the Gentiles, and they will listen.
Por tanto, quiero que sepan que esta salvación de Dios se ha enviado a los gentiles, y ellos sí escucharán.
For 2 whole years, Paul stayed there in his own rented house and welcomed all who came to see him.
Durante 2 años completos permaneció Pablo en la casa que tenía alquilada y recibía a todos los que iban a verlo.
Last verse, are you ready?
El último verso, ¿están listos?
He proclaimed the kingdom of God and taught about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance.
Y predicaba el reino de Dios y enseñaba acerca del Señor Jesucristo sin impedimento y sin temor alguno.
So when I first became the pastor here almost 14 years ago,
cuando de primero vine aquí a pastorear en esta iglesia 14 años atrás,
there were just a small handful of us.
Éramos un poquito de nosotros.
And on a Sunday night,
y en una noche de domingo,
we went on a 2-block radius of the church.
Dimos una vuelta 2 bloques alrededor de la iglesia.
And I walked down to the hotels.
Y paramos allá abajo en los hoteles que están en la playa.
And we asked them a couple questions.
Y le preguntábamos a la gente algunas preguntas.
And one question I asked,
y una pregunta que les preguntábamos,
was, how often do you think about God?
Les preguntábamos, ¿qué tan seguido tú piensas en Dios?
And this hotel owner said, never.
Y uno dueño de hoteles me dijo, nunca.
I said, so you see the ocean every day and you never wonder who created it.
Y le dije, tú miras el océano, ver todo, como sus olas todos los días y no te has puesto a pensar quién lo creó.
And she said, that's right.
Y ella me dijo, es correcto.
See, sometimes we can stop seeing what's right in front of us.
Algunas veces nosotros tenemos que parar a ver lo que está enfrente de nosotros.
Like yesterday, I was driving on Highway 18.
Como el día de ayer, estuve manejando por todo la carretera interestatal 18.
And sometimes when you're driving 35 miles an hour in a 55 mile an hour.
Y algunas veces vamos a 35 millas por hora o algunas veces a 55.
You get upset.
Yeah.
Tenemos que estar ahí.
And you stop seeing that the colors are changing.
Y tenemos que parar y ver esos colores cómo cambian.
And you stop hearing the birds sing.
Y tenemos que abrir nuestros oídos y ver cómo cantan las aves.
Have you ever thought, well, maybe God's slowing me down so I will notice and see with my eyes?
Es por eso que muchas veces tenemos que ir despacio y ver con nuestros ojos lo que Dios nos está poniendo enfrente.
And go slow enough to hear the birdies singing.
Y ir despacio y escuchar esas aves cantar.
I love Pastor Rob Baker, who was here for a couple weeks.
Amo al Pastor Roberto, que estuvo aquí unas semanas atrás.
He said, prayer is 95% listening.
Él dijo que el 95% de la oración es escuchar.
And I I totally agree with him, except I've said 90% of prayer is listening.
You know,
and I know that sometimes we go through difficult seasons in our life.
Muchas veces nosotros pasamos por por variedades de dificultades en la vida.
And sometimes it's hard to hear God.
Y muchas veces es muy difícil escuchar al Señor.
And this is when we go back to God's word.
Y es por eso que tenemos que ir a la palabra de Dios.
Especially the Psalms.
Especialmente a los Salmos.
And God's voice sounds like God's word.
Y esa voz de Dios suena en su palabra.
And when we're reading the Psalms,
tenemos que escuchar los Salmos.
God can begin to speak to us again.
Dios nos habla a través de ellos otra vez.
You know, we need that daily refilling and refueling by the Holy Spirit to hear God's voice.
Tenemos que renovarnos y cargar baterías para escuchar esa voz de Dios todos los días.
This morning, I woke up at 4:30 a.m.
Esta mañana yo desperté a las 4 y media de la mañana.
Was anybody awake with me?
¿Alguien se despertó por esa hora?
Yes. So here I was awake saying, God, what's going on?
Y me levanté y dije, Señor, ¿qué está pasando?
And God reminded me of this quilt store owner named Mary that I met in Garnet, Kansas.
Y el Señor me recordó a una señora que conocí en Kansas.
And Mary, in my 10 minutes in her store, she shared that her husband had died.
Y en esos 10 minutos que estuve en la tienda de María, allí en su tienda, me dijo que su esposo había muerto.
And she was having a really hard time.
Y estaba pasando por tiempos difíciles.
And this morning at 4:30 a.m.
Y esta mañana a las 4 y media de la mañana,
God said, look to see if there's a Nazarene church there.
Me dijo, corre, ve y a ver si hay una iglesia nazarena allí cerca de donde ella vive.
And sure enough, in Garnet, Kansas is a Nazarene church.
Y es verdad, allí en Garnet, Kansas está una iglesia nazarena.
And I listened to a really good message by the pastor from last Sunday.
Y escuché un maravilloso mensaje el último domingo del pastor que está ahí.
And then I thought, I wonder if there's like a grief share in Garnet, Kansas.
Y me pude yo pensar si había allí algo, allí en Garnet, Kansas.
And I looked it up.
Y me levanté.
And there's one that started this past week.
Y empezó algo allí esta semana.
In the hospital.
En el hospital de ahí.
That is run by this Nazarene pastor.
Esa iglesia se corre también por un pastor de la iglesia del Nazareno.
So I contacted this pastor.
Y hice contacto con este pastor.
I didn't call. That would be too early.
No le llamé, era muy temprano.
And I contacted the quilt store owner.
Y contacté a la dueña de esa tienda.
And hopefully she can go this week.
Y probablemente ella vaya esta semana.
Just like we're going to have grief share here in our church starting September 9th.
Vamos a tener también nosotros aquí, nos vamos a sentar en una noche de septiembre.
But isn't it just like God?
Pero todo eso lo es posible solamente por el Dios.
To reach someone 1,800 miles away.
Para alcanzar a alguien a 18 millas en el camino.
By somebody who just happens to wake up.
De alguien que despierta nada más así.
And think, huh.
Y piensa,
I wonder what God's up to.
¿Qué es lo que Dios quiere?
You know, God cares for you so deeply.
Dios se preocupa por ti muy profundamente.
And he loves you.
Él te ama.
And he wants you to know you're never alone.
Él nunca te va a dejar solo.
And God is speaking to you and to others around you.
Y Dios te está hablando a ti y a otros alrededor de ti.
To encourage you in your walk with Jesus.
Animándonos para en el Caminar con Jesús.
There is nothing that will energize you more than hearing from the Holy Spirit.
No hay nada que te pueda energizar más que esa voz del Espíritu Santo, oír esa voz.
God provides life abundant.
Dios provee vida en abundancia.
This is the kingdom of God.
Este es el reino de Dios.
Sometimes we're too busy to stop and listen to the Holy Spirit's voice.
Muchas veces estamos muy ocupados y no escuchamos la voz del Espíritu Santo.
Sometimes we close our ears.
Muchas veces cerramos nuestros oídos.
And we stop hearing the birds sing.
Y no escuchamos esas aves cantar por la mañana.
Sometimes we close our eyes.
Muchas veces cerramos nuestros ojos.
And we fail to see what God has created right in front of us.
Y fallamos al ver lo que Dios creó enfrente de nosotros.
Paul couldn't help but speak about the kingdom of God.
Pablo nunca paró de hablar de acerca del reino de Dios.
The incredible story of salvation.
Una increíble historia de la salvación.
Provided by Jesus Christ who died on a cross for our sins.
Proveída por el Señor Jesucristo muerto en la cruz del Calvario.
And forgives us.
Y perdona y.
And heals us.
Hay sanidad y.
And loves us. Mucho amor.
Hay amor abundante.
The kingdom of God is like finding the pearl of greatest price.
El reino de Dios es como encontrar la perla de gran precio.
The kingdom of God is like finding something you lost.
El reino de Dios es encontrar eso, algo importante que tú perdiste.
The kingdom of God is God's unlimited authority that he has placed in you.
El reino de Dios es como esa autoridad del reino de Dios que está en ti.
The kingdom of God is the King of Kings living in your heart.
El reino de Dios es como ese Rey de Reyes viviendo en tu corazón.
The kingdom of God springs from hope.
El reino de Dios, el reino de Dios es algo que nos brinda esperanza.
That God has been faithful in the past.
Porque si Dios fue fiel en el pasado,
he is faithful in the present.
Es fiel en el presente.
And God will be faithful in the future.
Y también va a ser fiel en el futuro.
He hasn't left you even for a second.
Él no te va a dejar ni un segundo.
Even if you're having a hard time hearing God's voice.
Aun cuando tengas dificultades para escuchar la voz de Dios.
He is with you.
Él está contigo.
He will not leave you or forsake you.
Él no te va a dejar, no te va a abandonar.
For the kingdom of God is for children.
El reino de Dios es para los niños.
Or those who are childlike in their faith.
O aquellos que son niños en la fe.
The kingdom of God is to be received like a child receives a gift.
El reino de Dios es como recibir, como un niño recibe un regalo.
Like, God, I'm so thankful for your grace.
Y decir, oh, Señor, gracias
I'm
por
so
tu gracia.
Thankful for Jesus.
Gracias por Jesucristo.
I'm thankful you gave me new life today.
Gracias porque me has dado nueva vida hoy.
See, in the kingdom of God, you are born again.
En el reino de Dios es nacer de nuevo.
And born of water and the Spirit.
Nacer del agua y del Espíritu.
You have to go through many hardships to enter the kingdom of God.
Tenemos que pasar por muchas cosas para entrar al reino de Dios.
And this is where Paul was.
Y esto es lo que Pablo estaba hablándonos ahí en la palabra.
He was falsely accused.
Él lo estaban acusando falsamente.
He was going through hard times.
Él estaba pasando por tiempos dificultosos.
But he continued to preach the kingdom of God.
Pero él continuó predicando acerca del reino de Dios.
For the people.
Para la gente.
Some received God.
Algunos recibieron a Dios.
Others did not.
Otros no.
1 Corinthians 4:20.
Primera de Corintios 4:20.
Says the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Poder.
Porque el reino de Dios no consiste en palabras, sino en poder.
Liars, thieves, cheaters will not enter the kingdom of God.
Los mentirosos, los ladrones, los idólatras, los borrachos, fornicarios, asesinos no entrarán al reino de Dios.
There is purity in the kingdom of God.
Allí hay pureza en el reino de Dios.
You know, Tony, I remember when my car was stolen from the seminary parking lot.
Yo recuerdo cuando me robaron mi carro del seminario, del parqueadero del seminario.
And I felt violated.
Y yo me sentía...
Somebody had been in my car.
Alguien llevaba mi carro.
Stripped my steering wheel.
Iban allí sobre la rueda.
Stolen my stuff.
Se habían robado todas mis cosas.
But the Lord had me like you pray for them.
Pero el Señor me dice, tienes que orar por ellos.
That they would turn to the Lord.
Que ellos vuelvan al Señor.
And become right with Jesus.
Que vengan a conocer a Jesús.
Because the kingdom of God is for those whose hearts are pure.
Porque el reino de Dios es para esa gente que de corazones impuros.
The kingdom of God is not something that can be observed.
El reino de Dios no es algo que nosotros podemos
seen.
Algo que podemos ver.
But the kingdom of God is in our midst.
Pero el reino de Dios está ahí.
It's the Holy Spirit.
Es el Espíritu Santo.
It's the Spirit of Jesus.
Es el Espíritu de Jesús.
Who changes our hearts.
El que cambia nuestros corazones.
The kingdom of God is here.
El reino de Dios está aquí.
The kingdom of God is a refreshing stream.
El reino de Dios es refrescar, ese caminar.
Of living water flowing from the throne room of God.
Esa agua que está fluyendo desde el trono de Dios.
Into our hearts.
En nuestros corazones.
For all who will receive.
Para todo aquel que la quiera recibir.
Paul was preaching with all boldness.
Pablo estaba predicando aquí con valentía.
And without hindrance.
Sin impedimentos.
That the kingdom of God is for you.
Pero el reino de Dios es para ti.
Many received the kingdom of God.
Muchos reciben el reino de Dios.
Others did not.
Otros no.
Some did not want to see.
Otros no quieren ver.
Some did not want to hear.
Otros no quieren oír.
Or understand with their hearts.
O no quieren entender en sus corazones.
For if they did, their eyes would be opened.
Pero esos ojos tienen que ser abiertos.
Their ears would be opened.
Esos oídos tienen que ser abiertos.
You know how, like, when you get off an airplane?
¿Tú te has sentido cómo se te bloquean los oídos cuando vas en el avión?
And your ears go pop, pop.
Y tus oídos hacen pom, pom.
And you can hear.
Y empiezas a oír.
It's like your ears would be opened.
Y ahí es cuando tus oídos se abren.
And the hearts would be opened.
Y también el corazón.
To receive all of God's goodness in the kingdom of God.
Para recibir todos esos buenas cosas que Dios tiene para ti en su reino.
The kingdom of God is for you today.
El reino de Dios es para ti hoy.
Verse 28.
Verso 28.
Therefore, I want you to know that God's salvation has been sent to the Gentiles, and they will listen.
Por tanto, quiero que sepan que esta salvación de Dios se ha enviado a los gentiles. Y ellos sí escucharán.
I'm so thankful that this happened because you and I are Gentiles.
Estoy muy contenta que esto haya sucedido porque tú y yo somos gentiles.
And today you are listening to the power of God's message.
Y hasta este día estamos escuchando nosotros el poder del mensaje de Dios.
And when I received Jesus into my heart,
cuando yo recibí al Señor Jesús en mi corazón,
and the kingdom of God filled me with its fullness,
Dios me llenó de su reino hasta fluir.
I've never been the same.
Nunca volví a ser la misma.
For this is what the kingdom of God does.
Pero esto es lo que hace el reino de Dios.
I've seen miraculous healings.
Es una sanidad profunda.
You know, Irene Williams was dead. She stopped breathing 10 years ago.
Miré a un hombre morir como paraba de respirar unos años atrás.
And several minutes later, she started breathing again.
Y algunos minutos después, él empezó a respirar.
And she said, Jesus is here, he's here, he's here. We've got to tell everyone.
Y él empezó a decir, Jesús está aquí, necesitamos decírselo a todos.
And she continues to live today.
Y él continúa viviendo hasta el día de hoy.
Down at Avamere in Newport.
Ahí en Newport.
And I saw her this week.
Lo miré esta semana.
Marty saw her too.
También, lo miró ella.
And she was reaching out her hands.
Y él levantó sus manos.
Because she was seeing Jesus.
Porque él miró a Jesús.
And she wanted us to know.
Y él quería que nosotros supiéramos.
It's okay.
Está bien.
When she's ready to go, she's going to be with Jesus.
Cuando ella esté lista para irse, sabemos que va a estar con Jesús.
This is the kingdom of God at work among us.
Este es el reino de Dios trabajando en nosotros.
His hands are open to you today.
Sus brazos están abiertos hasta el día de hoy.
He wants to speak to you.
Él quiere hablarte a ti.
When's the last time that God spoke to you?
¿Cuándo fue la última vez que Dios te habló a ti?
Was it this morning?
¿Fue esta mañana?
What's he saying to your heart?
¿Qué te dijo en tu corazón?
You know, sometimes God won't speak to us until we trust and obey the last thing he told us to do.
Nunca el Señor nos va a hablar a nosotros si no confiamos en él y hacemos lo que nos dice que hagamos.
We've got to say yes, Lord.
Tenemos que decir sí, Señor.
Your servant is listening.
Tu sirviente está escuchando.
I'm ready to hear your slightest whisper.
Estoy lista para oír ese susurro.
To my heart.
Directo a mi corazón.
Lord, will you give me fresh ears to hear?
Señor, dame oídos nuevos, frescos para oír.
Fresh eyes to see.
Dame oídos nuevos, ojos nuevos para ver.
The kingdom of God.
El reino de Dios.
Matthew 6:33.
Mateo 6:33.
Says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given unto you as well.
Buscar primeramente el reino de Dios y su justicia, y todas estas cosas serán, vendrán por añadidura.
To seek something, you've got to go on a hunt.
Buscar algo es algo que tú no paras cuando se te pierde algo.
It's like when I go to a quilt shop.
Cuando fui a una tienda,
and I'm looking for a certain fabric.
Y estaba buscando algo especial, algo de fabricación.
And it's been sold out everywhere.
Y ya habían vendido todo por donde quiera.
But maybe in one of the 40 shops I visit,
y pero en alguna de esas 40 tiendas que visité,
I can find that fabric.
Encontré eso que estaba buscando.
I'm on a hunt.
Y lo agarré.
My eyes are open.
Mis ojos fueron abiertos.
I know what I'm looking for.
Estaba sabiendo lo que estaba buscando.
This is how it is in the kingdom of God.
Eso es el reino de Dios.
That we're on a hunt.
Cuando te pones tú, listo.
We're seeking the fullness of God in our hearts and lives today.
Tenemos que buscar esa llenura de Dios en nuestros corazones hoy en día.
Jeremiah 29:13.
Jeremías 29:20
says, you will seek me and find me when you seek me with your whole heart. With all of your heart.
29:13.
No problema.
Y me buscaréis y me hallaréis porque me buscaréis con todo vuestro corazón.
Will you pray with me?
Pueden orar conmigo.
Lord, I pray that we would seek you and find you when we seek you with all of our heart.
Señor, oramos para que nosotros te busquemos y te encontremos con todo nuestro corazón.
Help our eyes to be open.
Ayúdanos a abrir nuestros ojos.
Help our ears to be open.
Ayúdanos, Señor, a abrir nuestros oídos.
Help our hearts to be ready.
Ayúdanos que nuestros corazones estén listos.
To see what it is you are doing.
Para ver lo que tú estás haciendo.
As you are reaching people 1,800 miles away and right here today.
Porque tú estás alcanzando gente, Señor, aún a lo lejos, a 18 millas lejos de nosotros.
Lord, we want to hear you.
Señor, queremos escucharte.
So will you speak even now?
Yo sé que tú nos hablas aún hoy.
Your servants are listening.
Tu siervo te está escuchando.
In Jesus' name.
Que lo pedimos en el nombre de Jesús.
All God's people said.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Will you stand with me?
this week, may you hear God speak to you in fresh and adventurous ways. As you go on a hunt to find the kingdom of God. That's right here. I love you all.
Los amo a todos.